Hello and welcome. My name is Kamil Tami and I will be your instructor inside this workshop. So this workshop is entitled in the course of graphic weekly graphic design workshops. And inside this workshop, we will see how we can make an attractive and attractive patterns inside the Illustrator. We will start from basic shapes and we will go and explain the process of making the whole pattern. And you can apply this pattern to any physical product. You can apply to this to a wallpaper, or you can add this pattern to such to an product such as a table or anything. So let's see how we can make this pattern. Let's dive into the screencasting. So we will here explain that we have this. This will be the final result that we will get after watching this tutorial. And these are three art boards, basic shapes, and some filters, some effects. And applying the gradient, all of these will give you this result. So let's go straight and make a new file. This will be the second workshop. And we have three art boards, and we have spacing of 100, and we have three columns. We have width of each art board, which is 1000 by 1000, and color mode, it can be CMYK or RGB. If you will print it, so going to the CMYK. If you want to make it digitally displayed, so it's RGB. And we can make all these options and click after that OK. So these are the three artboards. Firstly, we will make a layer. This layer will be the guides. And after that, we can go here and Control R to display this ruler. And this is, of course, the pixels. We can click and drag to get any guide such as this. So we want this guide to be perfectly inside the middle. So we can drag this guide and as you can see this guide is locked. So we will go to the guide and unlock guide, and then we can move this guide as we want. But we want it to be inside the center of this one. If you have using a new version of Illustrator, you can basically align it to artboards. But here I haven't any artboards option. So I will go to the window. And after that, we should. So we have this transform options. It says that in the X it's 700, so we will stick to 5000 pixel, and it's perfectly in the center. And we will copy it by Alt drag. This is another guide. We will make it in around one half. So this is 1000, and this is 500, and this is 1. So it's, it should be 1600, and let's go here and add another one. It should be placed in the middle, so we have 2200, which is 2200 and plus 15, so it should the total of 2017 pixel. And also we want to drag one from here, and its Y will be 200. Drag and copy, and another one will be 800. And this layer will be the guides. Let's make a new layer. This called the background. And this guide, you can double click this layer and layer option. Let's say it will be 10 or any color such as this. And this one also will be dark blue or black. And let's look the guide. and you can hide them such as this. And after that, we want to make the background. So we will going to make an rectangle and make sure that you have the smart guide to be enabled. This is one rectangle. Its color should be a black. So here, as you can see, we have make the guidelines of the three art borders, and now we will see how we can make a three black colors and three black rectangles which define our background. So let's go here, and after that we can make the second rectangle, and let's go here and make the third rectangle. As you can see, you can copy of course the previous one. And after that we have to enable or disable it. So this is the background, you can look it of course, and let's see how we can make our shapes. So it's pretty straightforward, and we will going to this item also and going to the star. We can make a star, and let's go here and add a new layer. It will be the star. Another layer, it called rectangle. And another third layer, it calls hexagonal. All of these layers you can define for them and color. So after that, let's draw the star. We are in the star layer, and we will go here and select the star. And as you can see, we have drawing the star. Using up arrow, you can choose your star. So we will make an star such as this. And I want to it to be this dimension. And again, we will select it to be a stroke of 4 point. This color of the stroke will be maybe green, and we have make the first one. So after that we want to lock the star and going to the rectangle, select the basic tool and make sure you have unlocked it. So I want to draw an rectangle. I want to draw the rectangle, which is a square, and the stroke will be maybe this color, 5 point, which is a stroke, and you can snap it. Which is the x of this value. And we can hide of course the guides anytime by using control and semicolon. So let's going to make the hexagonal, select this layer and unhide the guidelines. After that we can go to the rectangle, select this one and going to the polygon. Let's delete this one. So we select this polygon and select like this, and we can increase it to be 6 side, and alright, and the color will be maybe yellow or something from this direction, and we can make the stroke larger. So let's see how we can get now. So now we have made all the shapes, and we have make three shapes. You can make any shapes. You can start from a square, you can start from a circle, you can start from a star, you can use any shape, and you can start from one artboard. But I find this useful to define some different ways of making the pattern or the shape that we will make. So let's go here and try to start to making the effect. So I will start from the hexagonal, and let's select the hexagonal and make sure we have selected this hexagonal, and let's go to the effect, and after that distort, transform, and this is the effect that we will make today. So the scale will be scaled down to 92%, angle will be 4, and the scale stroke will be the same. Let's preview and again copy maybe 30 for now. So let's see what we have, and I think it's fine. Let's press OK. Without further ado, let's try to select our gradient. I will select this first gradient to be, let's double click here, and this one will be, let's select the RGB, and let's select it to be yellow from here, and the second one will be also a color, which may be this one. Alright, we have made our first shape. If you want to make it larger, you can scale, or you can go to the appearance anytime and disable any transform effect, or define it to be more angled, anything like this, or define the stroke to be more. So this is non-destructive way, of course. So let's go to the first second layer, which is the hexagonal. Select this one and going to the effect, transform, and let's preview. So this is fine for now, but I want to the angle, the cube is maybe 22, and the angle maybe 3 for now. Let's see what we have. All right, this is what we want. And if you uncheck this, you can see this is the effect, but each time it's scaled the rectangle, it's scaled the stroke, so it's scaled down until we see this effect. So this is the effect you see now. So let's select the star and command 0 to select this artboard, and command 0 to zoom in. And let's select this shape, going to the transform, and the same to be preview, but I think now we will make something different. So let's scale down to be 80 and cubes maybe 20 only, and again let's say angle will be 1 only, and let's say it will be 90. Let's see what we have. You may like this. Right, let's go for 10. Scale down to be 55. It's a process of trial and error, as you can see. Each time we will try to get the shape that we want to match. And all right, let's make it 95, and the angle will be 2. All right, this may be fine. Let's try 1, let's try 4. Alright, we will stick for 2, and scale, of course, this one, and just press OK. We will go to the gradient and try another different colors. So this one will be green. And this second color, all will be like this. And let's select also this rectangle. And going for the gradient. And this is the boss. Let's go for the gradient. Let's choose another color. And this one may be blue. And we can zoom in or zoom out, as you can see. So that's conclude for this video, and in the next tutorial we will see how we can apply this for any mockup or any real product or physical product. So after that you can go to export, save for web, or select any art board. Let's select this one, which is the first one, and this is the second one. So I will select this one and save for web. Select the BNG for all these settings. You can increase the quality to be original or optimized, and after that you can save, of course. This, so this will be saved, and you can scale it or scale out, so maybe 2000, and save, as you can see here. So that's conclude for this video. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. See you in the next lesson.